Hello and welcome. This is going to be your reading for October 16th through October 31st, 2019. Welcome back, subscribers, and welcome to those of you who are new. I super appreciate all your likes, subscribes, and comments. It really does help the videos circulate more and the messages are able to reach more souls who are needing whatever the messages are that come through. So thank you for that. All the information for our personal reading is listed below. You'll book directly through my website. Also, I am a master energy therapist and I specialize in distance energy healing and therapy. It doesn't matter where you live. I have clients all around the world at this point, which is really amazing. I'm so grateful for that. And we would schedule according to your time zone. So no worries on the time difference either. All the information is listed on the website below. You know, if you're feeling like you are working through something or you're ready to let go or you're feeling out of balance or just off, the energy therapy is very powerful to help you get back in alignment, get connected to your true self, and moving forward on the best path for you. So definitely take advantage. I have a 15% discount for first-time energy clients, so you can absolutely take advantage of that. You'll see that listed below as well. You can also reach me through InstantGo if you just have a simple question, okay? So I think that's it for Shop Talk. We're going to get straight into your readings now. Hello, Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and Jupiter. Again, this is for October 16th through the 31st. I've already fully shuffled, so I'm just going to get into this for you guys. We have a new moon in Scorpio on the 27th, which means the sun and the new moon are going to be in Scorpio. So that might be a little bit intense. Just be aware of that. Whoa, okay. They all jumped out at once. Okay, Aquarius, so I guess I'm just going to show you all four of these because they came out together. So hard to hold the cards. So first up, we've got Ten of Cups, Hermit, Four of Cups, Empress. All together, okay? So first up, I'm going to go through the Ten of Cups with you guys. I mean, this is the happily ever after card. This is the union, the love, the commitment, the emotional fulfillment. So I feel those of you who are in a relationship, this is speaking to you. For those of you who are not in a relationship, I feel this is what you're realizing you want, what you are ready for, or what you've been working towards. Okay, so I do feel like it's getting very, very close. For those of you who have been wanting a soulmate or wanting a relationship or that special someone to come in. With the Hermit card here, there's been a lot of lessons that you've had to go through in regards to love. There's still maybe a few, well, I shouldn't say there's always going to be more lessons, right? I wish I could tell you that one day you wake up and you've made it, no more lessons, but that's just not the case. It's never, ever ending. But that's a positive thing. And with the Hermit, you know, facing this Ten of Cups, I feel there's been some sort of an awakening or a spiritual lesson or something here in regards to love for you. This can be within your relationship. This can be within your thoughts and beliefs about a relationship. You may have actually fully shifted on, you know, you thought you wanted this, but now you've grown so much that you realize that's not important. You actually really want this type of partner or this type of connection. So however that resonates with you, but I feel like spirit and soul have been trying to shine a light in for you with messages around love and partnership and a commitment. And then with the Four of Cups and the Empress here, Four of Cups can be missed opportunity or like not being open to seeing the gifts. So again, with this Hermit card and this one lantern, I'm almost feeling like this one cup here coming out of the universe is the same as this lantern, the light that this Hermit has been trying to shine on you. You may have been too busy focused over here on different things in your life and missing maybe the message that soul or the universe is truly trying to give to you and shine a light on. I do feel there's something deep here for you, Aquarius. And this is interesting because your guys' last few readings, I have felt so much shift out of like the mental and mind energy into like the truly strong spiritual beings that you are. I feel like Aquarians are quite spiritual, and we are building to 2020, the Aquarian age. So maybe that's why you're kind of being woken up, and there's just a lot happening in regards to that. But I think, yeah, you may have missed opportunity, or you may have missed these messages coming through. So be aware of that through the end of October. I do feel like there's something still there for you. And with the Empress, I mean, the message could also have to do with you really standing in your power and receiving what it is the universe has for you. The Empress energy to me, male or female, is just very loving, nurturing, and very good at receiving, allowing gifts and messages and love and whatever it is to come into you without, you know, going out and chasing it down and trying to control the outcome of things. And as an air sign, it's natural to want to control control the outcome of things. So I think that's something that may be shifting with you guys, is letting go of the mind knowing what the outcome is and bringing it more into trust and flow. Trust and flow. That's really the message I feel here with the Empress. I also just heard the word nature. I feel it's important for you guys, wherever you live, if you can, just get out in nature and ground yourself and really tune in. Yeah, it's going to help ease the mind if you do have fears and worries about your path or what's next. Yeah, okay, so as I'm talking about nature and connecting and the importance of that, I've got the Nine of Swords here and the Five of Pentacles. So for some of you, you may be a little too focused on your fears, your worries. There can be money situations for some of you that are a little bit challenging, but I feel this Five of Pentacles is more representing like a disconnect. Five of Pentacles, it can really be about disconnect, being left out in the cold, leaving someone out in the cold. It can also really represent spiritual disconnect, okay? Which if you're really caught in your fears, your anxieties, your worries, kind of what I was saying of letting go and trusting more, if you're caught here, then yes, there's going to be a huge spiritual disconnect, because when we're caught in our worries and our fears, that completely cuts off the flow of trust and for the universe to shine the light in and give us some guidance. So that message is not for all of you, but it is for a good group of you. Okay, this fear and whatever this anxiety is, make sure that you're speaking up and really facing that within yourself. I do feel things are going to be shifting because we've got the Page of Wands here, which is like, whew, shaking it all off. You're focused now. You're back on your inspiration and your excitement and passion for life. So I just notice how light this Page of Wands is compared to these two cards. So you are going to be getting more clear of where you want to put your effort. This also, Page of Wands, can be somebody new coming in for you, a new hobby, a new passion, a new job. Yes. Okay. Okay, Aquarius, oh boy. Next two cards out, I've got the Five of Wands and the Eight of Swords. There's a lot going on for you guys this month with healing, I feel, and getting out of your own way. Again, I mentioned, you know, we're building to 2020, the age of the Aquarian, and you're really being support. I mean, we all are, but you guys especially are being supported in really letting go of any thoughts, patterns, beliefs, things in your life that are not in alignment with your highest and truest self. You may have a little bit of resistance around that. I mean, that's totally normal. If your soul is like saying, leave this job, you're miserable here, the mind is like, I can't leave the job. I need this job. This is, you know, what I should be doing. So there can be a little bit of a battle here between your soul and your mind for some of you. But I think that's part of the lesson. It's accepting where you are and then looking at ways that you can deal with each of those things, finding forgiveness, not being so hard on yourself, really lightening up on yourself. I know, Aquarians, you have very high expectations for yourself. With the Judgment card, it's asking you to just soften up a bit. You know, take the blindfold off. Don't be afraid to look at where you can grow and expand. I mean, there's nothing more rewarding than that. And the Judgment card really gives you, I love that that's the last card out, because it's giving you an opportunity for like a rebirth, a new start, a new beginning. Because when this Page of Wands pops up, whatever new thing this represents for you, there all of a sudden you are going to feel some resistance here. Because I feel like it's not going to make sense to the logical mind. To that strong mental energy that you as an air sign naturally have. So take that as something to be aware of, Aquarius, that you are going to have something new coming in. This can be love. Again, this can be love coming in with a partner that's totally different than what you ever thought you would be with. Okay, but turns out that's exactly in alignment with your soul. But you're like, no, I don't want somebody like that. My head wants someone like this. So just really being aware to shift between head and heart. I feel that's kind of the strongest message here for you guys. But overall, I feel the rest of October is going to be quite positive for you because you're getting more in alignment with you. And the Judgment card is bringing you a rebirth. And you've got the Empress. This is the energy that you want to be sitting in and feeling. So I think that's available for you as you work through any of these limits or maybe disconnects that you've been feeling. Okay, and the last message for you, Aquarius, guardian angel. So you are being supported. I mentioned that with the Hermit card. You guys are really supported here. There's a lot, you know, in the outer realms that's happening that we're not necessarily aware of, but there's a lot of work going on that is all in support for our growth. Okay, so don't be afraid to tune into that. Get into nature, tune into your higher self, do whatever you need to do to get out of the mental energy and more into the soul and the heart energy. Okay, I hope that resonates with you. If not, no worries. You can watch your moon sign, your rising sign, your Venus, or your Jupiter. Thank you for the comments below the video. I love reading through all of those. If you want to book a personal reading, the link is below. And again, I am a master energy therapist. I specialize in distance energy healing and therapy. So it doesn't matter where you live. I have clients all around the world and this is my full-time work. So thank you guys for keeping me so busy. Definitely take advantage. There is a 15% discount for first-time energy clients. So you can absolutely take advantage of that. And I think that's it. I'm wishing you a wonderful rest of October, and I will see you guys back here for the first half of November readings. Take care.